Located in the eastern region of Uganda, Bududa District has severally been ravaged by floods and landslides dating to years ago. This has since continued to evolve as it brings disaster every time its occurrence is announced. Its effects, without excluding deaths of many, have always prompted the government to intervene with short and long-term remedies to curtail the detrimental scars it leaves behind. In a bid to further safeguard people settling in the most prone areas in the district, the government has revealed a grand plan to resettle the landslide survivors to more convenient places.
We took a decision that each family starting with the Bududa area will be given 2 acres of land and 10 million shillings. We also have an organization called the Give Directory. I think they also offered to provide 7 million shillings to supplement what the government is giving, so that all those who live in the risky slopes of the Elgon Ranges are relocated to safer areas.
People living in mountainous areas have been asked to consider relocation before disaster befalls them.
People who live on the slopes of mountains should rethink their settlement and shift to areas which carry less risk. Actually, from a technical standpoint, we advise that the people should not settle on a slope which is 30 degrees and above in terms of the gradient.
In another revelation, the government has reiterated the move to merge a number of agencies in a bid to cut administrative costs and ensure efficiency in service delivery.
Those do not fall directly under what we are considering in this rationalization. So those will continue. In any case, under the judiciary, there aren't many agencies of this nature. So majority of the agencies fall under the executive arm. You will find, like Parliament, there are no agencies per se under the Parliament arm of government. So majority of these agencies, which are responsible for implementation and execution of government work, they fall under the...
As schools and other learning institutions look forward to opening for this year's first term, Minister Baryomunsi has cautioned school owners and leaders on licensing and accreditation.
Schools which should open are those that are licensed and authorized to run education services, because there had been a warning earlier on that illegal schools should not open until they have been authorized by the relevant bodies of government.
According to Baryomunsi, the government has also secured over 2 trillion shillings intended to renovate major roads in Kampala and metropolitan areas. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.